Hello everybody, welcome to your robotic pro. Today we are going to have a discussion on lambda expressions in cucumber, how we can use lambda in cucumber steps basically. So I will just give an examples basically. What you need to use lambda expression, first is that you have to use JDK 1.8 greater than 1.8 basically, and then you have to use cucumber java 8. If you just simply use cucumber java, you cannot use the lambda expressions. You have to use cucumber java 8. Okay, so this is a basic requirement in the pom.xml to use the lambda expressions. Okay, then we have step definitions. I just given three scenarios basically, and all are different types of scenarios, where one is like where I'm just getting the integer, another I'm just getting the string, and another I'm just passing the whole document. You can see it, like whole document I can pass it through a lambda expression. So let's go one by one. Let's go with this one. So I went to a shopping mall and brought 10 cakes. Now if I go to the step definitions, so when you use a lambda expression like java 8, cucumber-java 8, you can define the lambda expression like this. So in normal scenario, what you do, you write a method below the Jenkins keyword, correct? But in lambda expression, that does not happen. We have to create a constructor of that. Before that, we have to implement en. You can see java 8.en. Okay, so you just create a class and implement en, and then you create one constructor. Okay, and inside that constructor, we have all the steps for the lambda expression. Okay, so we have first scenario where we have just defined this one, like, okay, I went to shopping mall and I brought 10 cakes. Sorry, so if I go here and you can see I went to a shopping mall, you don't have to give annotations at the rate basically in the lambda expressions basically. So you have to just directly give given I went to shopping mall and brought cakes. Okay, then you have to pass this bracket. If you just read the java lambda expression lambda, then you understand this. So this is an argument. When you have to pass an argument, you have to just use this bracket. Okay, and then minus and greater than sign. If you have one argument, like you have to just use one argument or one line, then you don't have to use this curly braces. If you have more than one statement, then you have to use the curly braces. I have used the curly braces even though I have a one statement, but if you have more than one statement, then you can use the curly braces, otherwise you don't have to use it. Will go inside the this circular bracket. Okay, so this is the first step. So let me run one by one. So I'll just go to the feature file and I'll take this annotations and I'll just put it here and I'll just run it. So it has run it and this giving an example. So you can see print cake count 10. What I have given to the step definitions, print count cake 10. Now next, so you don't have to write the method for each of the steps. You can see given and all, and it will continue like this. Given and then when, all will continue like this. So if I go to the next scenario where I'm just passing the string, so I'll take this string annotations. I went to shopping mall and I brought a cakes. So this is, I'm passing a string. So just I go to the runner class, I'll change the tag. There's nothing changed with respect to runner class and all. It will be the same. Only the step definition is getting changed when you are going to use lambda expression. Okay, so you can see it. Print the item, which is a cake. So I'm just passing an argument as a cake, as an item. You can see it. I can pass anything which will go as a string. So in this step definition, again, string is an argument I'm passing the step, and how I'm receiving as a string is an item, and then it is going inside this and just printing the item. Okay, this is how the lambda expressions work basically. Okay, now if I go to the next scenario, this is very important. The reason is sometimes we have to pass a paragraph. Okay, so there will be a comma, then there will be a space, then a new line will start, then there will be a bigger line, then a smaller line, and we want to verify with some document. It can be a Word document, it can be a PDF. So when you read a document, it will come with all the space, comma, new line and all. So if you want to validate all the paragraphs and all, then this document is very important. So what I'm doing, I'm just passing a document. So what you have to do, 3 semicolons. Okay, 3 semicolons, in that you pass the document, it will go as a one whole string. It will not go line by line or a single single string. It will hold, this whole string will go, sorry. Okay, this will go as a whole string. Okay, so now go to the step definition. I went to the step definition. I went to shopping mall and I passed some string. I'm receiving that string and just I'm printing that string. So if I go to the feature file and just run this scenario, I'll copy this scenario and just run it. So you can see it. I'm just going to run it. It will print whole string whatever I pass into the feature file. So you can see it. With all the space and whatever I've given, it has gone there. You can see it. Okay. So you can, if you want to pass some paragraph of a strings and all, you don't have to pass in the form of table or in the form of examples. You can directly pass as a form of document. Okay. I hope you like my video. Please do subscribe. Have a good day.